Okay, so we will start with the border. Okay, after the border, we are going to put a center line. And very lightly, I am showing it a little dark, but it is very important that you make it a little lighter. Because later, after we have used this line for our drawing, we are going to erase it. And this is a landscape mode. This is a portrait mode, okay? Today we are doing all in the landscape mode. Now we are going to make a semicircle. So we'll start not exactly from the left side and not from the right hand. We're going to keep some space here. And in the middle, we are just going to make a nice semicircle. See the distance between the middle line and the how big the semicircle is. It's almost like three fingers of mine. So don't make it too narrow, don't make it too big. So now we are going to make another semicircle, but see the shape of that. So we'll start, we will leave this much space. I'll just show you. You don't have to do this line. I'm just showing you how much space we'll leave. And then we'll start another semicircle, a very small one, maybe one finger. And we are going to attach it near the this one. So it is a flat semicircle, a more flatter side. So if I measure it, it's like one finger. And then the second line will be just below this line, same, mirroring the above line. That's it. Now from here, you see, we are going to just make another shape. We are going to all do the basic shapes first, and then we are going to make a beautiful painting. So you have to be very good with the shapes. So we are going to make which shape? So maybe like that, and then attaching this one. So this is a triangle. Then we are going to give, it is a mouth of the dolphin, right? Then we are going to give the shape later. But first we are going to start with this basic shape, triangle. After that, this is, we have started a little bit here, not in this end. So we are just going to make another line and join with the semicircle that we had done. That's it. So don't make it too small or too big. It has to, you have to understand how big it is. If I make a line out here, you don't have to make a line. Just for you to understand how big the beak will be. Only this much. Just around 2 centimeters. And this is a very important characteristic of dolphin, which will make it separate from other animals and birds. So this part is very important. How we cut it from here and attached to the beak. And this part will remain the semicircle, which we will erase later. So in this triangle, this line is more slanting and more longer. And this is little shorter and more little bit straighter compared to this one. So now we will do the tail part. So tail part from this, the line which is absolutely below, we are going to extend it. And the one which is absolutely in the last, the semicircle, and we are going to extend it like that. And then we are going to make a line out here. And then we are just going to make the basic shape, which is a triangle. So from here, we are making a proper triangle. Then later on, we are going to carve the tail out of it. So how many shapes has made the dolphin? One triangle out here, one triangle out here, and semicircle. With these two shapes, we will be able to make the whole dolphin. But if we try to make it without the shapes, sometimes it is distorted. It's not proper. So it's always a very good habit to first see the shape of every drawing. You can make it simple and then make very complicated painting. First, we have to make the fins, which are missing here. So again, it will start with the triangle. So it will be this kind of triangle, this and this. This one is elongated and this one is little straighter. Now we will have to do more fins. So there will be one fin on the top. On the top of this, there are three lines right here. 1, 2, and 3. So we are going to do just below this one, maybe a little bit this side, more towards the left-hand side, almost in the middle of the semicircle. We are going to do another triangle. Same way. So this is going to be elongated and this is going to be straight. And one fin we are going to do on the last one. which will be also similar, this line and this line. But this will not be the full triangle because it is coming behind this one. So it is overlapping, right? But still I have shown the line. We can erase it later. So these, for this dolphin, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 triangles and a semicircle with two lines on the bottom. Now with this, we are going to make a beautiful, cute looking dolphin. So now, since we had done this part, we are just going to just make it a little smoother, like that, smoother. Same line, instead of very sharp cut, we will just go through it and make it smoother. And we are going to erase this one, this part of the semicircle, which we don't need it anymore, okay? And this one, what we are going to do, we are going to cut it here, little before this sharp thing, and then take it further here. So we'll have a curved little beak for the dolphin, and we'll take a one middle line like that and make a mouth for the dolphin. And then we are going to erase that pointy thing, which we don't need it anymore. Now we will try to carve out the fins properly. How will we do that? We'll do the same thing. We will do little curve and go little below that pointy thing and then do it like that and make this one little curve. And then if I rub the shape that we had taken help of, see how the beautiful fin will come out, which will look like this. So the line which I had shown was this one and this one, right? And on top of that, we made the fin. Now the same thing we are going to do here also, since this fin is coming from this, the first line, again, we are going to make little curve as we did in this one, but this fin is facing downwards. Again, the curve out here and the curve out here. From this one, it is a curve outside, and for right hand side line, it's a curve inside. That's only the difference. And then we have to erase the straight lines. We'll not make it so pointy, we'll curve it here also. Same thing we have to do for the one fin which is left behind. One curve outside like this and one curve inside. Now we cannot see the whole thing, so I'm just doing only this much. So it will be this way only. And I'm going to erase my triangle line because I don't need that anymore. Now we will do the tail. So I will put a point somewhere in the middle like this. See, a dot. And then with the help of this shape, we are going to go a little bit, little ahead. And we do like that. And then we'll attach this. See, this shape. Same thing we'll do from here. We'll take it like that. Do this way and then attach it. So because of the triangle, I've got such a lovely shape. It is not becoming thin in one side, fat in one side. I've got a proper shape what I needed. So that was because of the basic shape that I made. See, our dolphin is ready. So now we will do the C. Just scallop it. And then we will not need this horizontal line. We are erasing it. So now shall we make the clouds? So we are going to make line, one line out here, one line out here, and on it we are going to make cloud. So we will just make three scallop like this. 1, 2, 3. And here also we are going to make only 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And after that, we can just make a circle. A circle, not bigger or smaller than this. See, circle. And after we've made the circle, we erase the line and keep the cloud over it like that. So the circle will not be full, but you have to make the full circle. Otherwise, what will happen? The shape of the circle will not come right. You can make the full circle like this and erase it later, which is coming behind the cloud. And then we can just give lines. So we will take a gray color. And when you color, no, it should be in the same way as the shape of the dolphin is. Don't go horizontal or vertical. You have to go, if it is in this curve, you have to also shade in the same way. See? And small, small strokes. See, I'm doing with the same shape. This side, the down part, has to be done with a lighter color. So I can use a lemon yellow for that. Now, once you've done that, how we are going to do the sky? See, there's a new technique of doing the sky. We have any broken blue color, which is light blue color. And then what we are going to do, we're going to flat on the paper and then we'll drag it. We will not lift it from any side. We will drag the whole body along the paper.